This week, one of the biggest stories in the media was about Penn State and the horrific charges against his former football coach, assistant coach, that he sodomized all these and raped all these young boys, and that it was known to many in the Penn State hierarchy, including Joe Paterno, the revered 84-year-old coach who was fired. And now there's all kinds of criminal investigations. Lest this be too surprising, I think it's important to understand that this kind of horrific behavior has gone on since the time immemorial. In fact, I always find it fascinating how there are coincidences between what's in the Torah portion of the week the Jewish people read and what the events are in the world. Sometimes I think that we just change our hairstyles and our clothes, but it's clear that human nature stays the same. Because in this week's Torah reading, Parshat Vayera, that Jews everywhere in the world read from Genesis, it discusses Sodom and the sins of Sodom. And I think as you hear and remember the story from Genesis 18 and 19, you'll see so much in common. So it's the beginning of the Abraham narratives, and God says to Abraham, I have singled Abraham out that he may instruct his children and his posterity to keep the way of the Lord, to do just what is just and right. Then he says, God says, the outrage of Sodom and Gomorrah is so great, their sin is so great, I will go down and see if whether they have acted together according to the outcry that has reached me. If not, I will take note. And then Abraham starts arguing with God and basically says to God, will not the judge of all the earth do justice? If I can find 50 righteous people in that city, will you destroy it? And God says, I won't for 50. And they continue bargaining until it ends in chapter 18 with Abraham saying, if I can find 10 righteous people there, and God said, I will not destroy for the sake of 10. Well, evidently, Abraham couldn't find any because he stopped arguing then. And then God sent these two angels who had come to visit Abraham previously. And the text says in chapter 19 of Genesis that Lot was sitting in the gate of Sodom, and he sees these two men. He wants to give them hospitality. And they say, no, we'll spend the night in the square. He says, no, come home with me. And when they had not yet lain down to go to sleep, the townspeople, the men of Sodom, young and old, all the people to the last man gathered at Lot's house, and they shouted, who are these men? Bring them out that we may be intimate with them. In other words, they wanted to sodomize them. So Lot says, no, I beg you, don't do this. But then look what he says. Here's Lot, Abraham's nephew, in verse 8. I have two daughters who are virgins. Let me bring them out to you. You may do with them as you please, but do not do anything to these men since they have come under the shelter of my roof. He wants to give his daughters to these brutes in Sodom to brutalize, his young daughters, so that he would protect the hospitality offered to these two strangers. I mean, the thing is so insane. But of course they say, stand back. No, we want these men. They pressed hard against the door. The men then pulled Lot had gone outside. The men pulled Lot back into the house. And then all these people who were at the entrance of the house were struck with blinding light. So they were helpless. And then the men say to Lot, get your family out of here because God's going to destroy the city. Just amazing that we go back 3,000, 4,000 years of this story. And we have the story of sodomy and Lot offering his daughters. I mean, the crazy, immoral behavior. And then we see what happened at Penn State with this Sandusky allegedly raping and molesting and sodomizing these young boys, story right out of the Bible from 4,000 years ago. So I think one of the clear lessons for us to understand is that this stuff has always been there. God, sadly, it's always going to be there, and we have to just remain vigilant in every generation. As God said about why he wanted Abraham, why did God pick Abraham in the first place? This is the key, what we got to know in Genesis 18:19. For I have singled him out that he may instruct his children and his posterity to keep the way of the Lord by doing what is just and right, in order the Lord may bring about for Abraham what he has promised him. But that's the key, that we have to follow the way of the Lord to do what is just and right. And never assume that things are going to change. There's still going to be real evil in the world. There's going to be real awful behavior. But we have to remember what is just and right and do the way of the Lord. And so I think that is the message of both the Torah reading of this week and the horrible events that have really affected the whole nation about Penn State and the terrible behavior there.